Hello there, Ray here, and today I'm going to show you an upgraded version of my Endstone and Torch Farm. If you haven't seen my previous Endstone and Torch Farm, I will link it down in the description. I highly recommend you watch that because it's a pretty crazy invention that I did. Now this is an upgraded version of it. A couple of things changed with this version here, and I will go into that. My Endstone and Torch Farm allows you to get infinite amounts of Endstone as well as torches. Although you can craft torches, but with this one, they're already pre-crafted. Now the way that I got this to work is that when the exit end portal regenerates, it will produce endstone along the bottom here, as well as produce torches around the centerpiece here. Then I have a machine that will collect this endstone as well as the torches. Now typically the only way you can get the exit end portal to produce this endstone and torches is right when the new dragon is summoned in. So you'd have to put down your ender crystals and summon in a new dragon. I found a glitch where it allows you to be able to get this exit end portal to regenerate, including the endstone as well as the torches, just by doing some interesting things in the game. Now, this is something I showed in my previous endstone farm, but I later found out a way to completely automate that process. Now, with this one here, some things change in the game, like I said, and this one a little bit less automated, but you can still get infinite endstone as well as torches. So with my new endstone, all you have to do is relog once you have everything set up, which I'll explain a little bit later. But notice how there's no endstone here as well as no torches here. Now, once we leave the game and join the game again, you see that the game will reset the exit end portal, and this will cause them to be torches there as well as endstone to be here. Then you can see my machine is coming along, moving the endstone out of the way, and also this water is coming down and pushing these torches out of the way as well over to they break off and they get kind of pushed in these corners. Then we have a hopper minecart that'll go around and pick up the torches and place them into this chest here. Ooh, I got a lot of torches. Then you've seen the slimestone machine was coming along, pulling off all the endstone off of the machine or off of this portal here, pushing it down here. Then we have some more pistons which are pushing it over here. And here I have a blast chamber which is pushing in blocks and destroying them with TNT. Right now I'm just using Pi's TNT duplicator. And if like in 1.13 they're trying to remove this, so if that happens to get removed, then you can always use a normal piece of TNT, or you can come in and use my old style, like my previous endstone farm where I used withers to break it. But here we just have the TNT coming down perfectly timed so that when these blocks get pushed forward, they'll be in block 36 form, which is able to be destroyed by the TNT without removing any of the blocks and destroying them. And then the blocks will get pushed down by this water and put into this chest down here. I got some endstone array. And this is a way to get infinite amounts of endstone as well as torches in your game. The water that's used to remove the torches down below comes from up here. And since when the game puts in a new exit end portal, it will remove blocks all the way up to like Y level 90. I showed this before in a previous video, and it can be used to actually break bedrock as well as do crazy things. But when it does replace these blocks, it does not cause any updates. And this means that the water source up here will just sit here. So I have some observer blocks, which will update the water source, allowing it to flow downwards and to break the torches off. So with this design, you may notice that there is no longer the piston warping conveyor at the very top here that would warp the dragon out into lazy processing chunks. Instead, we are going to move the dragon through an entrance gateway portal and then send him out to an exit gateway portal. This is because of some changes in the game where they have removed that piston warping in some forms. So now it's easier just to send him through one of the entrance gateway portals, similar to my Dragon XP farm where I would send the dragon through one of these entrance gateway portals and they end up at the exit gateway portal. Now, some people think that this has been removed in the game, but it still exists in the game. CouchCraft and I were trying to figure out why this was no longer working in recent versions. So Couch looked into the code and discovered that not only was the game looking for portal blocks that were these normal ones that go around the exit end portal, but it was also ended up looking at gateway portal blocks as well. It happens that they changed the code so that the game would now recognize the end portal blocks as well as the gateway portal blocks being the same thing. And when it was checking for these portal blocks, it would say, hey, there's no portal blocks around this piece, but we do see a portal block way out here at this gateway portal. This is something they changed with recent versions. Because of this, this same glitch does not work exactly the same. But if you would happen to break out this portal block, then it will work again. Now this means that if you start a new world, you could easily do this just by ending up removing one of the portal blocks. But if you have a world where you have all your gateway portals in, you probably don't want to end up removing all of them since they're pretty handy. But if you would want to, you could make this work again. A little bit later after this discovery, we were working on my Dragon XP farm, and Narcoleptic Frog was looking up some stuff in the code for me about ender dragons, and he came across the same exact thing that Couch found in the code, where he noticed that the gateway portals were being put in the same category as end portals. So it's kind of funny how they would change this up, and they most likely did this on purpose to try to avoid this glitch occurring. The way that I recommend to build up my farm is to do this when the end island is somewhat new, or you have too many gateway portals around the outside. So here's a new island, and what you would want to do is kill the ender dragon that's here. So once you have killed the dragon, then you can just come in and build the farm up around this. So once you have built everything up, then you just want to come in here and kind of hold this water up like I have down here, and then you want to come in and open up the spots here and here on the portals. So you can just remove these portal blocks by clicking on the block beside this portal block with a bucket of water. And once you have removed at least those two spots, you can put down the two ender crystals. So this will resummon the dragon, and this will also reset the portals as well. And then you want to let the ender dragon get summoned in. Now, what you want to do now is go over to where you have your gateway portal from the previous one that was killed off. And in survival mode, you just want to stand right beside it. So if I just go over here and stand right beside this one, and I go in survival mode, you can see that I'm kind of unloading some chunks along the edge. You want to make sure that you load an entire island, so you might want to increase your render distance a little bit, so that if the dragon summons and he kind of flies off away from you, he doesn't get unloaded. So I'm going to press F3 and B, so you can see his bounding boxes. And now you just sit here and wait until the dragon tries to, he will try to attack you by running straight at you. And he'd normally do this right after he perched. Now you notice on top of the water pillar that we had over there, we had some endstone. This way when the dragon perches, he's not going to try to perch down by the portal. Instead he's going to perch on top of this endstone at the very top here. And so now the dragon is coming over and he's going to perch. So if I go back into survival mode, hopefully he will try to attack me right afterwards. And then when he tries to attack me, he's actually going to fly right through this portal over here. So here he's going to go. And yep, he went right through his portal and he got teleported away. Now this way, this is an easy way you can get the dragon away from your island. Now he is over at the exit gateway portal. And this is another way you can collect dragons if you want to. So a really simple way to get the dragon over out of your main end island. So now all you have to do is come over to the center here. Well, first you need to remove this portal block here. And I've showed a cool little trick about this before, how to remove these portal blocks just by putting a trapdoor there. And then if you would shift click on this trapdoor, it will just remove that portal block. So once you have removed the gateway portal, the game will try to resummon a new dragon in 1 minute from now. So you don't have a lot of time to mess around. But what we have here is a machine that will automatically detect when the endstone is placed in here when you relog. That's what this observer does. And it will just go into a clock and then we'll send a pulse around to start the whole machine. So if I just relog, and you want to make sure that you relog before the ender dragon resummons again. So if I just relog, the game still thinks that it needs to summon a new dragon, and it will also place in a new exit end portal there. And this way we can acquire the endstone as well as the torches. Have a nice little indicator light here which tells you that you can relog again, and just by doing that again it will be able to start all over again. Got a whole new set of endstone as well as torches, and the machine will acquire those. Now you do want to make sure that you relog each time and not wait 1 whole minute, or else the dragon will resummon there and then you will no longer have your end portal or your gateway portal to get rid of the dragon again. So then you would have to kill it and do it all over again. So with single player it's not too hard just to leave the game and rejoin it to get the portal to regenerate. But with multiplayer, it's a little bit harder because you would actually have to restart the server or have the server crash and restart on its own. Now, with single player, you can easily make a macro if you're into macros that would just leave the game and then just, you know, click here and then click back here and join the game and do this every so often. You can time it exactly with this redstone lamp here. Of course, if you're not into macros, then you can just come along and do this or like semi-AFK where you just kind of sit here and every time you see the lamp move, just exit the game and join again. One of the ProTech members, Ed Example, also made a teaser video about endstone right after I showed my first endstone farm, where endstone was given to him after indicator light went off and he relogged. If you would like to build up this endstone farm as well as a torch farm in your own world, I will provide the world download to this world in the description. So there you have it guys, an upgraded version of my endstone and torch farm. So, if you found this interesting, show me the like. If you'd like to see other crazy glitches like this in the game, subscribe, and don't forget to comment. Bye-bye!